back.
Good morning, the two. Attorney with the law firm of Peabody, Melton, and Stern.
She's here to sue us, boss.
No, not at all. Actually, Miss Stanton was sent here by her firm to deliver a check to the person holding the winning ticket on the Irish sweepstakes.
Who did win? Whose hand is it? Anybody I know?
Actually, you knew Ambrose Hoskins very well.
Ambrose? And boss, he's dead.
Which opens the door to a number of very interesting possibilities. My dear guests, I am Mr. Rourke, your host. Welcome to Fantasy Island. Stanton, I was unavoidably detained.
Of course. Shall we get down to business?
Yes. May I?
Please.
Thank you.
As you know, I was sent here by my firm to present this check to the winner of the Irish sweepstakes.
A Mr. Ambrose Hoskins?
Yes.
Now, according to his file, Mr. Hoskins was a retired merchant ship captain. And for the past 7 years, he worked here as your head groundskeeper.
Yes, that is true. Unfortunately, Mr. Hoskins passed away only last week.
There was another party named by the late Mr. Hoskins on the winning ticket.
Oh?
Who is it, boss? What's his name? Ambrose Hoskins? And best friend? Did Ambrose write that?
Yes. And I'm here on behalf of my firm to find his best friend and to present him or her with this check.
That's not going to be easy.
What Tattoo is trying to say is that Mr. Hoskins was not blessed with, shall we say, a very amiable personality. You may have some difficulty locating his best friend.
I'd be most grateful to you for any help you could give me in locating his best friend.
Very well, Miss Stanton. We'll see what we can do. Tattoo, since you are familiar with all the members of our staff, as well as most of the island population, I want you to look into this matter at once. And you will be in full charge.
Anything you say, boss. And like I say, it's not gonna be easy. Excuse me.
I let the cat out of the bag. Now everyone on the island is pretending to be Mr. Hoskins' best friend.
Yes. Tattoo, perhaps you've been looking in the wrong places for this missing millionaire.
What do you mean, boss?
Well, just that we are all creatures of habit. And as such, we usually keep those things we consider precious, such as mementos of close friendships, in a place that is most private to us.
I get it, boss. And boss' cottage.
His cottage? Could be. In any event, I believe it's worth checking out, shall we? Thank you, Tattoo.
Kind of spooky, Ambrose. Almost like Ambrose is still alive.
Perhaps he is, Tattoo. In a sense. Here, please. This will be of great interest to you. The loneliness of old age is little understood by those who have not yet walked in the constant shadow of death. I have known and suffered the abuse and indignity until finally I turned away from people. Only one person seemed to understand what it's like to grow old, to be without companionship. He used to come and visit me, asking for nothing. Only to say hello. I hold him as my true and only friend. His name is... Tattoo. Well, Tattoo, it seems you found the best friend you were looking for.
Tattoo? You're a millionaire.
Oh, I'm a millionaire.
Yes.
I can't believe this. Miss Tatum, I'm a millionaire. I'm rich. I'm rich. I can't believe this. This is fantastic. I'm rich. I'm a millionaire. Oh, this is fantastic. I feel it.
What's wrong, Mr. Tattoo? What's all that commotion out there?
Boss, they're all going crazy. Strangers are asking me for loans. Other people have I been there yet? My friends do like they don't even know me anymore.
Well, that's to be expected, I suppose. You see, a man's station in life often dictates who his friends can be.
Friends? They were more like a hit squad.
Well, then why not hire a bodyguard? Lots of celebrities have them. He would keep the crowns away. Ah, don't worry. I'm sure you will adjust. Which brings me to the reason I wanted you to see me.
I knew it.
Do you remember when we had so many guests who wanted to stay and live here after their fantasies were fulfilled?
Yes. That's when I suggested to have a working room to make room for the new guests. What are you getting at?
I'm afraid you can't stay on the island any longer. Regrettably, you'll have to leave on the morning flight.
But boss, I love it here. All my friends are here. I belong here.
I am so sorry. You must believe that. And I hate to see you go. But I'm also very happy for you. Think of all the wonderful things you'll be able to do with your money.
Boss, you always have the answer for everything. Do you know any way we can go around this so I can stay here?
I'm afraid not. It's always been your fantasy to be rich, Tattoo. Suppose I did let you stay. What would happen? Huh? Hundreds of people would follow your example, and then we would be so overcrowded we could no longer function. Fantasy Island would no longer exist as we know it. Would you want that?
No, never.
Well, now you see our hands are tied. You do know how much I'm going to miss you, don't you?
Not as much as I'm going to miss you.
You understand what you mean?
Yeah.
Do you?
I guess I do.
One of the essential elements to fulfill a fantasy is patience.
Look, any place you choose is fine with me.
Thank you, Tattoo. I'm happy you feel comfortable working with me. Ah, I almost forgot. Your plane ticket. We leave 10 sharp tonight.
Then, but you said that we're leaving tomorrow morning on the first plane.
Too much to do. I'll see you at the seaplane dock.
Excuse me for a moment. I'll see you in my office, all right? Thank you.
Oh, that's great. I'm going to be living in Paris, New York, and Aspen. You going to come see me?
Oh, I'd love to. That is, if I can ever manage to take the time off.
Was it Mrs. and Mr. Clement with you over there?
That to remember. Under the present circumstances, I cannot discuss the fantasies of our guests with you.
Boss, that's terrible. I can't believe that Ambrose wanted me to leave the island. He knows how much I like the place.
Yes. Well, perhaps he didn't take into consideration the circumstances, you know. I wonder what Ambrose would have done with the money had he lived to collect it.
I wish I knew.
I suggest you give some thought to it.
My boss, I don't have the time. I gotta leave tonight.
Well, you still have a few hours. Perhaps something will come to you. Something you may have overlooked.
We better hurry, Tattoo. We don't want to miss the plane.
Is something wrong, Mr. Tattoo?
Boss, I remember something that Ambrose told me a long time ago.
What?
About a dream he had. To be back with his old friends again. Well, he told me he wrote everything down and he was going to show it to me.
Where do you suppose he would have left such a message?
The only place he could be.
Where?
The cottage. Come on, boss. Where would Ambrose leave another message?
Boss, it's no use. I don't even know what to look for.
Well, it seems important, though. I wonder, where would a sailor keep something important?
In a bottle?
In a bottle.
A bottle? This could be it.
Boss, read it.
Dear Tattoo, I'm writing this to you because you are the only one who would understand. I miss the sea and the men who sail it. I long for their rough waves and their tall tales. Some nights I go down to the shore and dream of a place where men of the sea can all be together again. Where we could always hear the surf pounding against the sand. A place where we could sit and share our dreams and remember the days when we were young.
That's beautiful, but it's kind of sad too.
Tattoo, what are you doing? Aren't we going to catch the plane?
No. I don't have to be a millionaire. I'm a millionaire right here. I make people dreams come true. No amount of money will make me leave that.
You mean you don't want the $1 million?
Oh, yes, but not for me. Boss, for one time, I can make people's fantasy come true, all by myself.
That's right, Andrew. You certainly can.
Mrs. Stanton, will you please make all the arrangements necessary, please?
What for?
For the hornpipe, retirement home for mariners.
The hornpipe retirement home for mariners.
Sounds nice, no?
Very good, very good indeed.
Oh, it should be a big white house overlooking the sea in New England.
I'm sure I can find exactly what Ambrose would want. I'll get on it right away.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. Boss?
Yes?
It's kind of a shame that Ambrose is not going to be there to enjoy it.
Oh, he will be, Tattoo. He will be.
Hold it, boss. My turn.
Thank you.
Boss?
Yes? Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Tattoo,
I'll be in Cape Cod tomorrow looking at property. Mr. Rourke, I didn't come here for a fantasy, but I feel happier than I've ever felt before.
Thank you.
Tattoo, there is a small matter I need to clear up with you.
Oh, what is it, boss?
Well, it's in regard to your bills.
Bill? What bill?
Well, after all, you did have the most expensive bungalow on the island, and then there is champagne, caviar, the finest of everything. Look.
Boss, I give all my money away. It's going to take me 6 years to pay that bill.
Well, in that case, I'll have to charge you to... overhead.